tonight, New South Wales Ambulance responded to a 16-year-old female who had fallen down approximately 20 metres of the rocks. She was also accessed by a friend of hers who also needed to be extricated from that location. It was a combined rescue effort with police rescue and ambulance special operations teams and ambulance helicopter medical teams, with the assistance of Fire Rescue New South Wales also. It was a good combined team effort from all services involved. The patient was extricated up the cliff by police rescue, suffering abdominal and chest injuries. She's taken to hospital in a stable condition. It was a complicated rescue from a logistic and technical point of view. The initial paramedics were winched in by helicopter to do the initial clinical assessment. Police rescue and special operations then abseiled into the patient. Fire rescue assisted by cutting some trees down so that the patient could be winched up the cliff and then carried through the bush to the ambulances. This meant that the rescue incorporated several different strategies in order to get the patient to safety. Yeah, the patient's been transported to hospital in a serious but stable condition.
Look, the difficulty was gaining access for the paramedics and the ambulance and treating doctors. Once we'd established access for the patient, then we went about the process of conducting the rescue itself. Yeah, look, the location was the main difficulty, and the darkness creates its own problems and issues and safety issues for not only ourselves, but also for the paramedics, the treating doctors, and of course the patient. Well, for this this rescue, we used edge management, like a vortex machine, and set up our hauling system, ropes, and put the patient, once she was stabilised by the paramedics and the treating doctors, into a Stokes litter and was raised up through the scrub and to waiting ambulance. Yeah, look, for access, we used a reciprocating saw to clear our way through, and that made obviously access easier for the doctors, paramedics, and our rescue guys to access and egress as well. Yeah, look, important message is obviously for around cliff faces is don't go over the safety fence that's in place. It's there for a reason, and especially at night, there's presents a greater risk where you can't see the edge, you're not sure where you're walking, and unsure of your footing can end in dire consequences. Fortunately, tonight the patient was recovered with injuries and has been taken to hospital and subsequently being treated.